After its founding, the Czechoslovak Republic was searching for a national identity. In this respect, of course, architecture should play a role. And in the person of Josef Gočár, designer of this building, a capable craftsman was found, one who would create just such a style, national Art Deco, also known as Rondocubism. Legiobanka, which you can see here behind me, is the greatest icon of this style, which blossomed during a short but fertile period of our architecture in the early 1920s. Already before the First World War, during the era of Cubism, Josef Gočár had sought to create a so-called Gesamtkunstwerk, a complex work of art that would include not only architecture, but also sculpture, decorative art and painting, and he always invited his most talented colleagues to join him.
Architekturu, ale také sochařství, dekorativní umění a malířství. A k tomu vždycky přizval své.
It was not until after the First World War that he composed the facade of this building and enlisted the help of two of the nation's most significant sculptors, Otto Gutfreund and Jan Štursa.
Práci dva naše nejvýznamnější sochaře, Otto Gutfreunda a Jana Štursu.
The heads depicting sites of the most important battlefields where the Czechoslovak legionaries fought are by Jan Štursa. The frieze is the work of Otto Gutfreund, who himself took part in the action of the French Legion. His frieze depicts the return of the legionnaires from the battlefield and their involvement in peaceable work in the restored state.
A ten vrys znázorňuje návrat legionářů z bojiště a jejich zapojení do mírové práce v obnoveném státě.
The most important area of each bank is, of course, the grand entry hall. The architect Josef Gočár also considered it quite important, and while on the facade he sought the cooperation of the sculptors Otto Gutfreund and Jan Štursa, for the interior he invited another colleague, František Kysela, the leading graphic designer of the epoch, the Rondocubism period.
Interior přizval kolegu grafického designera Františka
Kysela worked on the decorative ornamentation of this grand hall, which has such a powerful artistic appeal, and is also among the highest internal spaces from the epoch of national decorativism.
Podílel na dekorativní výzdobě této haly, která má takovou mocnou výtvarnou působivost, a je to jeden z vrcholných vnitřních prostorů epochy národního dekorativismu.
Josef Gočár was definitely among the greatest architectural talents of the nation. His students often reminisced about his adjustment to the Academy of Fine Arts.
Žáci vzpomínali na jeho korekce na Akademii výtvarných.
He would silently take stock of his students' projects and then pull a tiny pencil stub from his pocket and in the corner of their sketches or plans, draw his own idea, his own solution. And it almost always hit the proverbial nail on the head. This most certainly was the case with the Legiobanka.
A tato jeho jistota, s kterou nalézal správná řešení, vyzařuje i z jeho stavby Legiobanky.
Gočár's elegant solutions radiate from the exterior in the powerful facade looking onto Na Poříčí Street. And in the interior, the monumental scale, which he brought in from the outside, is in the inside staircase, in his elaboration of detail and colors, and lend the building a certain optimism, a joyfulness that the nation needed.
Budově i jistý optimismus a radostnost, kterou ten národ potřeboval.